On August 24, 2006, in the early morning hours, lightning struck the south wing of St. Catherine Commons, a senior living facility located in Kenosha, Wisconsin.
Fire ensued and quickly devastated nearly half of the building. All residents, close to 400 people, were safely evacuated with no loss of life or injury.
Within minutes, the first fire trucks arrived on scene to what would become a full-blown five-alarm blaze. Upon arrival at the still actively burning building, Service Master quickly instituted emergency procedures in preparation for the end goal of saving as much of the structure as possible. As onlookers watched the firemen apply an estimated 8 million gallons of water to the fire, Service Master personnel were already placing phone calls to key vendors in preparation for what was to become a nearly 3-month-long preservation project.
Once the building was cleared by the fire department, the first order of business was to make the building safe for workers to begin the removal of wet building materials. Removal of wet drywall, insulation, carpeting, and other materials was a slow, tedious process due to warm, humid temperatures and hazardous conditions. Over 150 dumpsters were utilized in the removal of the building products. In the beginning, the main focus was on corridors and other public areas, allowing time for select personal items to be removed from the apartments, such as wallets, checkbooks, jewelry, and other essential belongings. Over the course of the next 5 weeks, crews typically consisted of more than 100 people in order to accomplish the labor-intensive task of stripping the building down to the 2x4 walls. Drying equipment was brought into the equation early to protect areas that were not damaged as severely.
As many as 6 generators of up to 400 kW capacity were used to power large commercial desiccant dehumidification units. These units are designed to remove excessive amounts of humidity in a short period of time by infusing warm, dry air into the affected area via large plastic tubing. The units are designed also to be used in conjunction with high CFM air movers to deliver maximum drying output.
300 high CFM air movers were utilized in conjunction with the dehus to facilitate and achieve a dry standard. Areas were monitored daily with moisture meters and infrared cameras. Reports were generated daily to record and monitor the overall drying process. Nearly 2 miles of cabling and cords were needed to power up the small army of various pieces of drying equipment.
On the north wing, where smoke damage was more prevalent, air scrubbers were implemented with VaporTech deodorizing canisters to neutralize unwanted smoke odors. Upon arrival into areas that were marked no entry, we found numerous articles of people's lives flushed down the halls and steps from the 8 million gallons of water the firefighters used to extinguish the blaze.
Complete devastation ran rampant as though a tornado ripped through the building. All that remained was heavy charring and the loss of personal property.
With sirens going off, there was no time to gather personal effects. On the south side of the complex, all residents lost something. Some lost everything.
In addition to the temporary electrical power, Service Master coordinated numerous other subcontractors to provide essential services such as plumbing, heavy commercial equipment, and operators. Many hundreds of technicians, laborers, supervisors, and management were needed to facilitate the preservation project. The overall scope of work required thousands of man hours to prevent any further damage to the already charred, saturated structure. Thanks to the many vendors who participated in this huge endeavor, work progressed quickly and smoothly through the heat of the summer. In order to minimize the overall loss, workers and staff were on site 7 days a week, 12 to 16 hours a day.
Inconvenience to owners and residents was held to a minimum due to the tireless efforts by all who were involved. The quicker the emergency services and mitigation could be completed, the sooner the restoration could begin. Many town hall meetings were held to keep residents posted on daily progress. On behalf of the displaced tenants, ServiceMaster worked closely with a local moving company to extract salvageable contents to storage pods on site, where they could then be safely viewed and retrieved at the convenience of the residents.
ServiceMaster would like to thank the many personnel at Capri Communities for their tireless efforts and the opportunity to serve them and their residents.